I'm Dave, and welcome to the Canyon Chasers Garage. Today, we're going to be answering a question from one of our loyal viewers. Javier Santos asks, will a more expensive helmet save my life better than a more affordable helmet? Javier, thank you so much for this question, and it's actually a pretty common question. Is a more expensive helmet safer than a more affordable helmet? Well, once we got into answering this question, we realized it was a much more intricate topic than we first anticipated. We've all heard the maxim, you get what you pay for, and if you have a $10 head, buy a $10 helmet. But that's a dramatic oversimplification of the helmet question. We should also note that the end user has a significantly larger impact on the effectiveness of a helmet than the helmet itself. Having a helmet that you like to wear that fits well and is worn properly on each and every ride greatly increases your chances of reducing an injury due to a motorcycle accident. For sure, the helmet has to be good enough, and we're going to get into that. But also, we're going to limit this discussion to full-face, one-piece, fixed-chin style helmets. There are other styles of helmets out there, but we feel like this helmet provides a better basis for discussion because the material safety of the helmet is less sensitive to user choices while riding. The question you pose, that is brand X inexpensive helmet just as good as brand Y expensive helmet, is a very good one, but it's also very difficult to answer. The problem is, nobody is really funding very expensive and time-consuming studies to definitively answer this for us in a very concise way. So we as consumers have to look at what information we do have to come up with an answer that we are most comfortable with. There are actually three different ways to answer this question. First is what you've seen in most official literature. Basically, if a helmet meets the safety standards, it will provide the same level of protection as any other helmet with the same standards. This is the legal answer, but it doesn't really shed a whole lot of light on the subject. The second way to answer the question is that yes, most likely a more expensive helmet is going to provide a greater level of protection. Why? Oftentimes, race clubs will track things like concussions based on helmet, and typically riders wearing more expensive helmets suffer fewer concussions. Also, when we look at the NHTSA random testing results, we see that lower cost helmets have higher fail rates than more expensive helmets. Particularly when we omit failures caused by improper labels, things that don't actually affect the helmet's performance. When we look at racing, particularly MotoGP racing, where they throw away valve stem cores after a single use because too much money is on the line to leave anything to chance. These riders all wear the top shelf, most expensive helmets money can buy, because a rider missing even one race can potentially cost a team millions of dollars. And lastly, let's look at history. If we look at the most expensive helmets of 5, 10, even 20 years ago, the safety features found on those helmets are common and even standard on your most basic entry-level helmets of today. So that leads us to believe that the most expensive helmets of today, the safety features found on those helmets, are going to become standard on entry-level helmets of the future. Safety features such as dual-density impact-absorbing liners and advanced shell technologies. But let's step back for a minute and take a look at this subject from a completely different angle. The fact is, there isn't one great answer because while we are not engineers or test experts, even the people that are these things can't agree about what's most important when it comes to protecting your head from impact during a motorcycle accident. Why is this so hard to quantify? Well, mostly because a motorcycle accident is a highly dynamic and variable event. What is important for protecting you in one type of accident may be completely irrelevant or even detrimental in another. To keep it simple, there are two major camps in the motorcycle helmet world, and that's SNEL and BSI. Now, please understand that we are basically just summarizing very complex standards and tests that take tens of thousands of dollars to develop and employ. But both of these different standards seek to objectively quantify the type of protection that a helmet can provide to a rider. These two standards are divergent, with the SNEL standard generally producing a more rigid helmet than a BSI standard. Why is this? Well, the BSI standard aims to lower the impact force measured in Gs that is transmitted to the rider's head in the initial impact, where the SNEL standard requires that the helmet be able to sustain multiple impacts. Which is better? Well, let's just leave it that both standards are about equally represented by riders in the Canyon Chasers team. But what about the DOT standard, you ask? The United States Department of Transportation, or DOT, allows helmet manufacturers to self-certify to this standard. And at present, there is no oversight by the U.S. Department of Transportation to verify these helmets are actually meeting the standard. And as such, Canyon Chasers cannot recommend any helmet that only meets the U.S. DOT standards at this time. We realize we still haven't even answered the question, is a $600 to $1,000 helmet better than a $200 one? Well, the answer is probably. But the reason why it might be better isn't that it costs more or that it has more features. We feel the reason why a more expensive helmet is oftentimes better has more to do with the user behavior around that helmet. Because it costs 3 to 5 times as much, the end user is much more likely to take proper care of it, for starters, making sure that it stays clean and protecting it from accidental drops. But keeping a more expensive helmet stink-free is made easier by the features that more expensive helmets have, such as removable cheek pads and liners to facilitate washing. These features also make it much more easy to customize the fit of your helmet. As we identified earlier, a quality helmet that fits right and is worn on every ride has a much bigger effect on rider safety than the price of the helmet itself. We strongly encourage you to seek the help of a professional when purchasing your next helmet, and that you try on lots of different makes and models. Left to our own devices, pretty much all of us will buy a helmet that's slightly too big, and that compromises the effectiveness of the helmet. Also, oftentimes these professionals can customize the fit of a helmet through inserts or interchangeable cheek pads that are provided by the helmet manufacturer to make your next helmet the perfect fit for your head, your style, and your safety. Helmets really are a marvel of technology and innovation, and we haven't even scratched the surface as to how and why they work as well as they do. Thanks so much for watching. We hope we've been able to shed some light on this very complex and intricate subject. If you have any questions for us, please email us at questions@canyonchasers.net, and be sure to check out our website, canyonchasers.net, for more how-to videos, product reviews, questions and answers, travelogues, and much, much more.